Here's the new toolbox. Batteries are in here. We just hooked it up, it started right up. Here's the fuel tank on here. And this is about 57 gallons now, 58 maybe. We gained about 10, 11 gallons over the stock tank. One thing left to do, I'm gonna have to put a 90 on this or put a check valve in here as it's so narrow. It's only 6.5 inches deep. So when I fill it, it'll come out fast, but we'll figure that out. Here's the gray tank. And I believe this is in the 20 some gallon range. I'll have to do the calculations on that. But there'll be a T fitting here. One will go back to the shower. One will go this way to the sink right there. And then there's a drain valve under here. Hopefully you can see that. I'll have a valve on that hooks to hose that can go to the ground and we can drink. Just usually we just let it pass through. We don't use the tank, but a couple times that you're at a commercial campground, you want to turn that valve off and use your tank so you're not going on the ground, if that's the rules. And yeah, pivot's done, toolboxes are moved. The last thing left is there'll be another toolbox here that'll be exactly like that one, only no batteries in it, and that'll be on this side. And then we'll take it out of here and get it to the mechanic to get some mechanical things done. We have new shocks, some air leaks, things like that. So that's the update from this side of town. Next, I'll give you an update on the other side of town. And now on the other side of town, we've got some things going on here. I managed to get the water level valve wired up. There's a wire that's powered behind here, but there's a wire from here that comes down right there to the sensor right there that I put in. This is just a float sensor. I'll put a link to it in a picture here, but I tested it before I put it in and I just secret flexed it in. So then when you hit the button, it'll just turn it on, turns on the light in the gauge and power to the sensor down there. You can see it's empty now because I've got no water in it, but I tested it before I mounted it in there and it worked great, full to empty. So that's done. Over here, I've got the cubby. This panel isn't completely installed yet, but we'll have a storage cubby under here next to the bed. A 110 outlet here that I wanted for cooking items, usually up here. And then we have two switches here. First one will be for, I have two accent lights, one underneath each toe kick down there. These are 1 watt osmium LED bolt lights. I use these in the van as well, although I use the 3 watt version in the van, but these are just 1 watt lights. And I've got them mounted down underneath each side. They light up all the way back, puts even dim light back here. I'll show you a picture here. And the bottom switch will be for something similar on the bedside back here. I'll probably have a couple underneath the cabinets over here, maybe two more up there. Not entirely sure about the bedside yet, but that's what those two switches are for. And then we have two USB outlets here to plug in phones, whatever there. So that's the progress over here. Started the truck up today, right after I made that video, and started right up. So he should have the other storage box done this week. And then next week I can take the truck over to the mechanic to get some things done there. So progress, slow but steady. I guess that's what wins the race, right? Until next time.